أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Here I am trying to just show you the calculations and the free body diagram for the experiment on friction. The video has been already uploaded in the blackboard. The lecture was delivered by Dr. Azam Sana Khan. So I am only showing you the calculations here. Now see, there are two tables in your report. In one table it says metal plane surface, and in the other table on top of it is written rubber plane surface. Okay, in this metal plane surface, in the table you have got how many rows? Three rows are there. Okay, in one it is shown as friction plate, then it shows as wheels, and then after that it shows the last one as roller cart, something like that. Okay, so you have totally three there. Now in the next table you have got another three, right? Rows I am talking. So totally we have got six experiments here. Okay, I am showing you the free body diagram of the first table. See, here I have written what? Metal plane surface. And what we are putting, see, this is the metal plane surface in the bottom. This is your metal plane surface. Now here what you have got, you see here, you have a, follow the cursor. See, you have a friction plate. Above the friction plate, you have got a cart. Above this cart, we have put how much weight? 400 grams weight we have put here. So see here, I have written here as what? Friction plate plus cart plus 400 grams weight, which I have forgotten to write here. So you see here, weight of the cart is how much? It's already given to you. It is 1.4 newtons. And then weight of the friction plate is 1.1 newtons plus 400 grams. 400 grams, if you convert to newtons, it will be 3.9 newtons. Okay. If you add all these three, how much you get? You get 6.4 newtons. Now here I have drawn the picture. Now this is hanger weight. Hanger weight is how much? 160 grams. If I change it to newton, how much I get? 1.57 newtons. How did I get this? 160 gram divided by 1000 will give me kilogram. Kilogram multiplied by 9.81 will give me newtons. Okay, I have newtons over here. So the weight of the hanger is acting like this. So what will happen here? It is trying to pull it, is it not? See here, by how much force it is pulling? This force, 1.57 newton. So this is pulling like this. So now the friction will be in the opposite direction. So what is the friction? F. Now here total weight, that is this total weight, it is acting down. How much is this? 6.4. How do you get? You have it here. See, follow the cursor, you have it here. So the normal reaction acting upward is R. R should be is equal to how much? R should be is equal to 6.4 newton. Okay. So what is the formula? Formula for coefficient of friction is mu. Mu is equal to F divided by R. F is 1.57 divided by R is how much? 6.4. So how much did you get? 0.25. This is the coefficient of friction. Now let's go to the second case. In second case, I have the metal plane surface, plus what I have done, I remove the friction plate. There is no friction plate. I will only keep the cart with wheels. It is there. Plus 400 grams weight I have to add here. Okay. When I put 400 grams weight, see here, I am showing you here in the picture. You have 400 grams weight here. You have cart here. This is the plane surface. So there are the wheels in the cart. What will happen? It will start moving. Right. So what is the hanger weight? Only 20 grams. See, very little. If you go up, when you have a friction plate, how much was the hanger weight? Mu 16 gram. So here it is how much? Only methane gram. Methane gram, ashrine gram. So if you convert it into newton, how much you have? 0.196 newtons. Okay, so it is pulling the cart by force how much? 0.196 newtons. So where is the friction? Friction force act in the opposite direction like this, F. Now the total weight acting down, how much? Weight of the cart 1.4 Newton already given, plus how much weight we have put, 400 grams, that will be 3.9 Newtons. So all this put together is how much? 5.3 Newtons. This is acting down. So R equal and opposite, 5.3 Newtons. F is equal and opposite to this, 0.196 Newtons. So what will be the value of coefficient of friction? 0.04. See here, if you see this case, it is 0.25, because this is sliding. Here it is what? Because of the wheels, it is rolling. So coefficient of friction will be very less. That's why if you have a wheel, you can move it easily. Okay. Now in the first table, you have got the third row. In the third row, the last stuff. Okay. So now you have got what? Plain metal plus what I have done now? I have put a roller cart. Okay. Roller cart plus your cart and then plus weight 400 grams. What is the weight of the roller set? 2.2 Newtons plus the weight of the cart is 1.4 Newtons. It's already given to you. 400 grams is 3.9 Newtons. It becomes how much? 7.5 Newtons. See here, you have got this one weights, you have roller cart, and then what else is there? 400 grams you have put. 400 grams plus this cart plus in the bottom you have roller cart. So, wahid itne talata. So, you have all these three. So, what is the total weight acting down? 7.5 Newtons. How much it is pulling in the hanger? You have 60 grams. You have got 60 grams. So, which is 0.59 Newtons. So, it is pulling by 0.59 Newtons and this is going down by how much? F is 0.59 Newtons, R is equal to 7.59, so you put here 0.07 Newtons. So, which is having the least coefficient of friction? That is these wheels, because you have only four wheels, okay, two on this side, two on the back side. Now, if you go here roller, how many wahed, itne talat, arba khamsa, whatever is there. So many rollers are there, so many lines of contact are there, so friction is little more. So, sliding friction is the highest. See, sliding friction, if you go 0.25, the least friction is rolling friction, that is 0.04 wheels. Okay. In between you have got rollers, because there are too many rollers. Okay. But you need too many rollers in places where you have heavy load. Like you can see in SABIC, so many machines come, they bring big truck which has maybe more than 100 wheels. It is just like roller cart. On the roller cart, you keep boiler, you know, they transfer here in the Royal Commission, the SABIC area, you can see. From the port, Mina, it will come to company, you can see big trailers with many wheels. It is similar to this, okay. This is regarding your first table. Now go to the second table. In the second table, what you have? You have got rubber plane surface. Again, same three things. You have got friction plate plus cart plus 400 grams. Friction plate weight we know 1.1 and then the cart is 1.4 and 400 gram change to Newton is 3.9 Newton. So, this become how much? 6.4 Newton. Okay. Now, see here what I have. I have got the cart, in the bottom I have the friction plate, here I have 400 grams, here in the bottom I have a metal plate, it is a rubber sheet, rubber plane surface, okay, 540 grams. Now I make the free body diagram, so how much did I get? 0.83, this is what, this is my coefficient of friction. So now see here, if you have a rubber surface, what happened to your coefficient of friction? It become more. See here, it is how much? 0.83. Whereas in the first case where it was a metal surface, it was 0.29. So this means if you have a rubber surface, automatically the coefficient of friction will increase. Why? The weight tries to fix, go down inside the rubber. It gets stuck. If you want to run on road, it is easy. If you want to run in sand, rubble, it is difficult, like this, okay. So, 0.83. Now, in the second surf, in the second table, you have rubber plane surface and wheel cart plus 400 grams. Here there is no friction plate. Ala tool, you have got these wheels. So, weight is there, wheel cart is there. This weight is acting downward. How much? 1.4 plus 3.9, that is 5.3 acting down. How much is the weight it is pulling down? 15 gram. So, which is 0.29 newtons. If you see here, so what is the coefficient of friction? 0.055. Compare this with this one. Here it is how much? 0.04. Yani this case is little more. Why? Because the rubber is there. These wheels try to go down inside the rubber. That's why friction is little more. The last case, you have got the roller set. On this one you put the weights. So how much weight? 50 gram, that is 0.49. If I pull it, I have here 0.06. okay, so this is what you have to do. So you have to prepare your report. You have your handout. From the handout you prepare the report, and then you have two tables. In the tables fill the values and then make the calculations and free body diagrams like this. Write your conclusions and then just submit your report. So the time for submitting report is till when? The time for submitting your report is till 4th of April. You have got till 4th of April. You can just submit the reports. Okay. Thank you very much. I think with this it is easy for you to understand. Right?